Desperation and Enlightenment. Al began to think more seriously of returning to Catholicism. Embarrassed and uncertain, he went back to his old parish and found that a new priest who didn't know him was in charge. That made it easier. In the process of telling the new man that he wanted to return to Roman Catholicism, somehow the name of Calvin came up. In the next 15 minutes, to his utter amazement, Al discovered that this priest knew even more about Calvinism than did Pastor Jim. A well-worn copy of Calvin's Institutes of the Christian Religion was pulled from a shelf, and the priest began to read a section he was sure would settle any question in Al's mind of returning to the true church. Al almost jumped up and shouted, "Alleluia!" when what Calvin had said about baptism was read to him. He could hardly believe his ears that, according to Calvin, his baptism as a baby into the Roman Catholic Church had made him one of the elect. All he had to do was believe the promise inherent in his Catholic baptism. Al was ecstatic. The Catholic Church had done more for him than he had known. So he was one of the elect, after all. Calvin himself had said it. All Al needed to do was trust his baptism. But this new assurance lasted for only a few days. Was his faith to be in his baptism as an infant, too young to understand anything, and at the hands of a Catholic priest, who himself taught and practiced a false salvation? Was that really the biblical foundation of eternal salvation? Well, Calvin had said so. What about the true gospel he had believed, the power of God unto salvation, and as a result had been born again? If being baptized as a baby, when he didn't even know what was happening, had made him a child of God, as Calvin had insisted, even to the persecution of those who disagreed, then what was the point of his believing the gospel? No, he couldn't accept that, even if Calvin had declared it. Al had finally come to a fish in the Calvinism pond, too large to swallow. Now he faced new doubts. If Calvin had been so wrong about infant baptism, and there was no doubt that, like Luther, he had been, maybe the rest of his teaching was equally false. Why should he believe Tulip at all? It seemed impossible that Calvin could have written such heresy as he had about baptism. Yes, heresy. There was no other name for it, but the priest had shown it to him right there in the Institutes, and Al had looked it up for himself when he got home.